Good afternoon, evening, morning, wherever you are, Mathletes and Filmmakers, where I am. It is Monday, May 27th, 2013, and this morning I woke up and I thought it was June, but it wasn't June, which means you get one more day of One Shot May, and I get to use this guy some more, which might continue because he is actually super useful in keeping these videos on track. So the first thing we're going to talk about is job updates. So I went to my little interview thing on Tuesday, which I talked to you guys about last week, and I said I would talk to you today about where I am now, and it's pretty much the same place I was. I went and I did the interview, and they gave me a reference form to give to somebody to fill out to send it to them by Friday. She did that, she sent it in, thank you very much, and I haven't heard back from them since, so maybe they're just taking the long weekend off, and I'll hear back tomorrow on something. But as soon as I know anything about this job, which is, like, of all the places I've applied, this one has gone the furthest as far as, like, hearing back from people, I will let you guys know. But interview felt good, so I hope that the whole thing goes well and I get a job. I don't know. It'll be minimum wage, 25 hours a week tops, but hey, I will at least be employed and making some kind of cash, so there we go. What else have I done? King of the Nerds. Are you guys ready for this? I'm gonna put down my little stabbed man because this requires some talking. Anyway, so if you want to go back and look at my first video, the first video on our page, it was called Introduction to the Mathlete and the Film Major, which was the first video that we did, and it was about a year ago. What? Holy crap, it was a year ago. Wow. Well, anyway, on that page, somebody went and commented. They said, "Hi, we'd be super interested in you auditioning for King of the Nerds." It was something along those lines. I don't have it in front of me. But they asked me to do King of the Nerds. And they asked Susan and I. So we sent them an email. We said, "Sure, we'd be interested." And like literally like a minute and a half later, somebody came back. They were like, "Hi, call us and we will talk you through the audition process." It was like, okay. So I was talking to Susan. Susan was like, do it, call. So called, and I called, and I was calling Los Angeles, and I got Erin on the other end, and she was like, "Hi, who are you?" I was like, "I got your email about auditioning for the King of the Nerds." King of the Nerds, by the way, is a game show contestant thing on TBS, which is kind of like Nerd Hunger Games, where it's basically the King of the Nerds is the one who makes it the furthest, and each week there are challenges, and people get eliminated one by one, and it's good fun for everybody. So I called and Erin picked up and she was like, "So are you the Mathlete?" And I was like, "No." And she was like, "Ah, okay, let me get acquainted with who you are. Who are you?" And I was like, "Well, I'm the film major." She was like, "Okay, okay. What are your nerd cred? Like, what's your nerd cred? What are your nerd credentials?" And I was like, "I went to Maggie Walker. I did AP classes. I'm just graduated as a film major. I was on the robotics team." She was like, "Whoa, robotics team. Super excited. Tell me more about that." And I was like, "I was the PR officer. I made t-shirts and buttons." And she was like, "Okay, did you, like, build the robot at all?" And I was like, "I can file like a pro. Like a pro. I can use drills. I got this stuff going." She was like, "Did you do programming or electronics?" And I was like, "No." She was like, "Okay, tell me more about film stuff." And I was like, "Here we go." So I went on that and we were talking for about 10 minutes and she talked me through the audition process. She said, "Okay, you're gonna have to make a video that tells us about who you are. Make it really, really big and be like, yo, I'm a nerd and here's my nerd stuff." And she was like, "What is your most prized nerd possession?" I was like, I don't really have a prized nerd possession. Like if anything, hold on one second. Like if anything, I would say that my nerd possessions either are the posters you see behind me, which I got out of a magazine and they still haven't come down, so it's a lot of Glee posters, plus a Starkid poster and Doctor Who, and I'm trying to see what else you guys can see in the frame. True Blood's over there, there's a Zefron poster, hidden behind an Ireland poster over there, because it was creeping me out that he was staring at me while I slept. And I don't know what else you can see, there's another Harry Potter poster, Wizarding World of Harry Potter stuff, but stuff that I like my nerd thing would probably be this. How to Train Your Dragon Live mug, which I literally love to death. It's got the little dragon stuff. I don't think you guys understand how much I love How to Train Your Dragon. It's my favorite thing of all time. Of all time! If anything other than that, like if I had to pick something else that was my nerd thing, I would probably pick this. And it's my wand that I got at the Wizarding World of Harry Potter from Ollivander's. And it is Neville Longbottom's wand. Because really, pretty badass, and he was always my favorite character, but whatever. That is beside the point. Just, like, so I was like, okay, maybe I'll pick those things and I'll talk about those. But then, like, I started thinking about it, and I told people that I was auditioning, and they were like, oh my gosh, do it. You're going to have so much fun. And I talked to my parents were like, sounds interesting. You know, tell us more about it. And I was like, ooh. And then like, when I had to start talking about it, I had to start thinking about it. And I was like, okay, let's think about this really quick. And what I realized was that like each of the people on the show fit into a kind of stereotype of nerd. And I wasn't sure that I fit into that kind of stereotype, nor did I really want to be categorized into stereotypes of nerd. Because there are, like, nerd is a gradient. It's not, like, chunky selection of nerd. You can go on any spectrum and it goes in all directions, wibbly-wobbly, timey-wimey nerdness. And it's a three-dimensional spectrum that you can't really place yourself in for any purpose whatsoever. I don't know, like, I know I'm already at, like, 5-6 minutes of this video, so I'm just gonna, like, kind of wrap this up, because I still have a lot of things to talk about. I just decided that I didn't want to audition for it, I guess. Aaron, if you ever come back and check on this video to see, like, where my video is, I'm super, super sorry, but I didn't want to do it, I guess, is the best way to say it. Like, I really, like, it's in my head, like, the reason why, but I just can't articulate it. So, it was a fun opportunity, and I was super excited, and it was cool just to even be thought of for it. So, thanks, but no thanks. And I guess if you have a season 2, I will check it out. Moving on to the next topic we're gonna talk about. I went up to a graduation party this weekend in Delaware. It was, like, the 4th week in a row that we have driven, like, forever to go somewhere. Third or fourth? Because third for me, I think. Because the first was moving out of Quinnipiac, the second was going back to Quinnipiac for graduation, and the third was going up to Delaware for the graduation party. But it was fun, it was worth it, and we got to see, like, that side of the family, like, the, like, those cousins I don't really see a lot, because, like, whenever they're there, we're not. Whenever we're there, they're not. Just, it, like, it doesn't work out all the time. So it was cool, like, to see them and, like, hang out. And they're really cool people. Me and my brother get along with them great. And, I don't know, fun times to hang out with them. So congratulations, Melanie, on graduating. Super proud of you. And have fun in France. She's going to France. Out of control. Crazy. She's gonna go teach people in France. Like, jealous? They have, like, a 3-hour day. I'm like, ah. Kill for that. Anyway, I guess I don't have to now because I'm a graduated college student, but then I have grad school. Anyway, so what else do I have? We saw The Great Gatsby and we saw Star Trek, which was fun. Great Gatsby, I loved, but the music, I was like, you're a little out of time for some of your music. But other than that, I loved it. I want Leonardo DiCaprio to win an Oscar super, super badly. And if he doesn't, I'm going to cry for him because it's out of control. It's been long enough. You need to give him an Oscar because he's earned it. And for Django, I was like, he's gotta have it now. And he didn't. I was like, poof. I feel like the people at the Academy are just like, ha, we're gonna nominate him again and then not give it to him. I'm like, you guys suck. Anyway, we saw that. We saw Star Trek Into Darkness. And, you know, I was excited to see Star Trek in general, but as soon as Benedict Cumberbatch came onto the screen, my mom, like, was in the theater next to me. And she was like, I was like, I know. Anyway, so that was a lot of fun. It was an exciting, action-packed thing, and we just got back from that. We saw that today, and I was like, what? And so we got home, and then my mom was like, so what was your video about today? And I was like, crap, I have to go do my video. So here we are doing my video, and what else do I have to talk about? Ah, two of my friends just started dating, and I just want to talk about that really quick because I called it a long time ago, and they watched these videos, so they're going to see me talk about them. Booyah. I hope it works out for them. I hope they're happy. And I mean, obviously they're happy. They're like, they're Facebook official. And I'm like, ah! Anyway, like literally when I saw that they were Facebook official, they had already told me that they were together. But when I saw they were Facebook official, I felt like, oh my God, I can't remember her name. Like that girl from The Graduate, when she sees Ben come in at her wedding and she's just like, Ben! Like that was my reaction. And speaking of Ben, we're gonna move right on with this thing. I just put on Facebook, I was like, yo, guys, when are people in town to hang out? Because, like, we have a group of, like, my, like, Virginia Richmond-based friends, and we all, like, hang out when there's, like, spring break, winter break, those kind of, like, breaks, summer break, obviously. So I'm like, when are you guys free to hang out? We'll go, we'll do, like, Carrytown perusing, or we'll get lunch somewhere, or we'll see a movie, we'll do something. And Ben was like, I'm in DC until August. And I'm like, I hope you step on a Lego. So that was a flawless transition from them to Ben. I was like, Bam! I could not have planned that out better if I wanted to. But this video is now 10 minutes long because I love talking to you guys. And I don't know. Like, I had a lot of things today. I mean, admittedly, I had a lot of things to talk about. But yeah, I am super, super excited to see where my job goes. Sorry, King of the Nerds. Star Trek, you were great. Great Gatsby, you were great. Melanie, congratulations. My friends who are dating, congratulations. Ben, you suck. Come back from DC whenever, because, I mean, by the time it's August, I'll be in California. Ouch. Anyway, for the film majors, I'm Caitlin. For the mathletes, Susan. Susan! When are you coming back? It's been too long, Susan. You need to come home. Come back to YouTube for me, okay? I can't. It's just it's really hard because I have to do these videos, and I'm doing them, like, twice the usual length because I feel like we owe them. Whoever's watching, our like 20 subscribers, who we love very much. But Susan, whenever you come back, it would be great. Or just like even anything. I miss you. I miss you. Come back to me. For the film majors, I'm Caitlin. For the math leads, Susan will be back whenever she's back. And for everybody else, thank you so much for hanging out with us today, and we will see you next time. Bye.